Здравствуйте, товарищи, and welcome to our Let's Play of Betrayer. And I know it's been a little while since I've recorded, but things have been pretty busy as of recently. But I wanted to sit down and do a Let's Play of this game because I saw it on the Steam sort of front page. You know how on the front page they have their featured games that slide on by. And I saw this game, I looked at some screenshots, I'm like, you know what, this game looks friggin' awesome. Based totally on its cover, based totally on the description that I read, and I'm like, you know what, sometimes you just gotta take a chance and see how things turn out, and I figured, why the hell not, let's do a Let's Play on it. So without further ado, let us begin. Yeah, I kind of know this is like a horror game. It's a first-person shooter. I saw some skeletons, and that's about it. That's all I got. So, pretty good. Yep. So what I think this opening sequence is trying to convey is that actually only one person worked on this, but they were split up into shards of other people, and then when they came together, they actually created a human being that was very talented at making video games. Alright, so I got 18 coins. Wow, I think I might actually have to turn down the graphics on this game. It's lagging a little bit. So I'm curious as to what I'm going to spend my coins on. Wait, there's someone there. Okay, shot an arrow into this thing. This was on the front page. Oops. How do I read that again? I don't know who you are or why you've come here, but you should turn back, lest you become trapped in this place as I am. You know, I always hate it when these spirits are so vague. Like, why don't they just tell me what the hell's going on the first chance they get? You know, I'm sure if they explained it to me really clearly, instead of, like, increasing the mystery and making me want to explore more, then I'd just leave. But, okay, looks like we've got a bow here, and a store. Sorry, I missed that note again. Reminders, you can use your compass to locate dropped items, such as loot or arrows. Arrows can arrows sometimes deflect from armored enemies. Listen for a distinctive ratchet sound. Okay. But I can't really... Okay, I've already got 16 shots in my quiver. What's all this then? Because your well-being is important to me, both fiscally and sentimentally, I should advise you that enemies are easiest to slay if you catch them unaware. For their rage makes them stronger. Shots to the head will also inflict more grievous injury than those to the trunk or limbs. Rely on me whenever you find yourself in need of deadlier implements of warfare. Cordially, John Howe, Merchant. Jerks don't make themselves known to me either. So is that guy an enemy? It's, okay, let's be very, very quiet. Ha! Okay, he sounded like a dog when I shot him. What did he leave me? Silver necklace? Crude pistol, but it's broken. The weapons you recover from slain adversaries are generally of poor quality, both being both feebler and more cumbersome to employ than you may desire. The weapons I offer are guaranteed to do harm and do it faster. Oh, I like his sales pitch. I am immediately interested. I just have to steal more items from random crates and knights that roar at me. Another hint totem. Tomahawk. It was remiss of me not to mention that enemies are more likely to discover you if you are moving. Crouching makes you significantly harder to detect, and allows you to move quietly. Use the wind to your advantage. Gusts mask your footsteps, making it easier to run up behind your foes without alerting them. Interesting. Very interesting. Okay, there is red in these leaves. Fortunately, the enemies are glowing red, which makes it easier for me to spot them. There's a fortress up on the hill. Seems like, if I want money and loot, that's probably the place it will be. But it also was probably the place where my mysterious adversaries are hanging out. Truly a beautiful, beautiful game. Just the wind and the way it interacts with the plants and everything. Okay. Oh, we got a fast travel map. Dear sir or madam, I hope that the bow I gave you has been of reasonable service. I would encourage you to consider some of my finer wares. I accept coin as barter, as you see fit. Check back any time to me and see what I may have acquired. Cordially, John Howe, Merchant. So, ooh, a musket. How much is that going to put me back? $450. Short arrow, tomahawk, crude charm of vigor, crude charm of grace. Okay, well, I want to save it for that musket. Oh, just. Indian arrows that were more likely intended for the head of the century. So we're somewhere, I don't think we're in Britain, but we're obviously in somewhere that was colonized by Britain. Oh, I don't know what the hell that was. Damn it. Drinking water from barrels restores your health and refills your water skin if you have one. The Indian king, whom they call Werowance, was much pleased by the gifts of tools and trinkets and gave us in return an abundance of corn and bear meat, which is excellent victual. Okay. Well, this guy's clearly seen better days. Though the figure appears human, it is only ash and ember. Okay. Well, that's creepy. true charm of solid soldiery. Did it say? Yes. Okay. Is it equipped? Yes, it is. Cool, cool. An ornate bell appears to be in good condition. It could probably be remounted from where it was hung. Collected bell. Well, it's just my lucky day today, I guess. Uh-oh. Another ash figure. Whatever did this probably wasn't human. Bone. Looks human. Something appears to be buried here, but the soil is too hard to dig into with your bare hands. You can drink from your water skin and restore yourself at any time. Be sure to refill it at open barrels. According to our prisoner, the Spaniards seek to destroy settlements that might be used for privateering against their treasure fleets, and will surely come at us again. We need reinforcements to repel further attacks. Well, something tells me you didn't get those reinforcements. Can we go into any of these buildings? So I have two different arrows, one for a longbow and one for a short bow. Nope, this is where I put the bell, I guess. Ding dong. Okay, we've entered a trance-like state. I don't like the looks of this. I'm waiting for one of those guys to come back alive. What happens? I can't ring the barrel again. Okay, oh, I can. Okay. This looks like a spade. I dug up what appears to be a human eyeball, although it feels more like a stone. It's strangely heavy and warm in your hand. It seems I can see things that I could not see before. Well, that's convenient. Oh, it'll take something more than my troll to dig this up. Okay, good. I can kill them. I've dug up a petrified ear. Like the eye I found, it's heavy and warm. Seems I can hear things that I couldn't hear before. Well, that's nice. Paper scrap. The Lord Governor has determined that we cannot spare any men to send to Fort Henry. For we are harried constantly by the naturals, who have recently grown more hostile towards us for unknown reasons. Probably because we obviously built a fort on one of their graves. I think that's a ghost. I've dug up a tongue. The question, is it friendly? It's not red. Let's go talk to him. Wraith, where is Martha? Who is Martha? My wife. Who are you? I'm Captain William Eastgrove. Where did you last see her? On the hillside, where I was sitting, where we were sitting together. I was holding her hand, talking about our son. I shall find her if I can. Oh no! There's the maiden in red. I hate to interrupt you, but who you're talking to? I was speaking with a wraith named William Eastgrove. but I see no one. He appeared in the dark when I rang the bell and vanished when daylight returned. In the dark? How can that be? The sun has not moved in the sky. Are you certain of what you saw? I couldn't see him until I found the strange eyeball. Well, I'm very forthgiving of information to this stranger. That is unsettling discovery. An odd thing to pick up. Personally, I found the tongue more unsettling. I hope you didn't lick the wraith, I hope. Though I confess I am suddenly curious about what that might taste like. Who the hell is this person? Who are you? I can't remember. I am sure that I have lived here. This place is familiar. But it's like a dream. I can't quite recall. Do you remember anything? My sister, I've been searching for her, but I can't remember what her name was either. Perhaps she is hiding from the Spaniards, for they seem more like beasts than men. Take that, Spaniards. Spaniards, but I have seen no one but you since I awoke from the forest days ago. I assure you that there are no more Spaniards here. Not anymore. They seemed real, though. Like the darkness and the wraith? What did he want from you anyway? He was searching for his wife. I would help you find her. But it is hard to track when one cannot see what one cannot see, and I must seek my sister. Please let me know if you see her. We are twins, and she should be easy to recognize. Where should I find you if I have news to report? Let us meet in this fort for now. I should also like to learn more of the outcome of your search for the wraith's wife. I cannot help but worry what's become of her. Very well. Okay. I remember we lived here for a time after we arrived. There were many skirmishes with the naturals in those days until we finally made peace with them. Do you think the ash figures were the people who lived here? Which ash figures? Have you not seen the figures that look of ash people? Are you trying to scare me? That sounds horribly unsettling, but I've seen no such thing. Yeah, it was horribly unsettling. I want to go back in time. Great, now I can hear creepy noises. Oh wait, this guy. William Eastgrove, leave. Goodbye, William. Nice chatting with you. Okay, well. Good and done. Now you're over here. Yes, I am. Okay, well. Forest Edge, Fort Henry. I guess I should search for the Wraith's wife. Let's head out this way and see what we find. I'm thinking we might have to do it. Ugh. That was creepy. A gust, like, blew through my room at the same time that a gust in the game blew through. It was really unsettling, actually. Oh, it doesn't look like there's a whole lot here. Jump, jump, jump. Who's that? It's another Spaniard. I shall approach with caution. Okay, that's what happens when I hit the listen button. Oh my fucking god. Well, this is not going well. Oh, shit. Oh, my God. Okay, they killed me. Each time you fall in battle, you drop valuables you are carrying. If you die before you retrieve them, they will be lost forever. Okay. I didn't lose anything, it looks like. Besides all those arrows that I shot. Which I want back. God damn it. Alright, well, let's try that again. Okay, well, they've spotted me. I will lead them back to the fort and fend them off. Quick, help me, Red Maiden. Hey, all right. Well, no, those bastards cleared out of the way. We can move forward. So yeah, when I hit X, it does that, whatever that is. Spaniards that for some reason sound like dogs. Oh, there he is. Glass bread. Or glass. Oh, I think I said glass bead, actually, not bread. Here's where I died last time. Oh, I did lose all my coins. How many coins do I have now? 186. I'm not really sure how to find the Wraith's wife, but I will continue exploring. Fortunately, they don't seem to be too concerned about the whole... Holy crap! Run, 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 run! Drink that water! Drink it, drink it, drink it! Oh my god! He is throwing a rock at me. Oh, I think I hit him. Alright, we gotta use guerrilla tactics to beat these guys. Where's Fort Henry? Where'd it go? Where'd they go? Oh, they're just all chilling out. I have no idea if I'm hurting this guy or not. This
bastards, man. I am, like, out of ammo.
Alright, gotta fall back to the fort.
Fortunately, these guys can't seem to throw to save their friggin' lives.
Alright, Red Maiden. Sorry, I've led them right to us.
But no, close the thing.
No.
Okay. Well, fortunately, he didn't kill me far from where I spawned. So that was very nice of him.
Hey, all my money.
Well, now I gotta buy all that. Man, those bastards, they really messed me up. Something told me I probably shouldn't go back there, but I really want to go back there. Can't let them beat me. If I get the map, what do I see? Nothing in terms of cities or villages or anything. Oh, sweet. I got a rusty musket. Just what I always wanted. Ow. Okay, I think I might be trapped. Yeah. Nope, never mind. I managed to escape the rock. Okay, well, I picked off these guys. Okay, the guy's big and angry. Yes. Oh shit. Alright, you big bastards. Or bastard. Oh wait, there's still a small bastard left. Alright, now it's just down to me and my musket. Just taking eternity to reload here. Just don't worry about it, my friend. And we'll be back.